And let's start with Ray Fittipaldo.
Hey, Stephon. Short week playing against a Ravens team that ran for 265 on you the last time. What kind of adjustments do you have to make in that short period of time, and you know, how do you do it in such a short span?
We, like you said, they did run for 265 yards against us the first time we played them. Of course, we want to reduce that number drastically. We just got to play more sound football when we get a chance to play them this Thursday. We just got to play our best game. They got great athletes on that side of the ball, and you see what happens when you get them in space.
Let's go to Brooke Pryor.
Yeah, Stephon, you guys are 10-0. I know Mike Tomlin said you're not really talking about the undefeated season, the possibility of that. That's still in the future, but is there more pressure that comes each week stacking these wins? I mean, it kind of feels like a Jenga tower that's getting taller and taller and more precarious each week.
I do like that game. That's a great game. That is. But no, we don't really talk about our undefeated season at all. And we literally treat every week as if it's a new week. And we always keep preaching the type of games that we're in. And this is a five-star matchup once again that we're in. And we need to make sure we're prepared for that. The end of the day, the goal is to make it to the Super Bowl. And what record we have to make it there doesn't really matter.
Christopher Carter.
Stephon, you guys, you got another sack on Sunday. Bud got another sack on Sunday. That gives Watt with 9, Dupree with 8, you with 7. What can you say about the chemistry that you guys have up front doing it again this week, adding to that sack total?
All of us been playing together for a while. We got prolific edge rushers to help make the quarterback step up for me and Cam Hayward. You know, Cam Hayward is the great defensive lineman too as well. We got a lot of guys that could get after the quarterback and cause havoc. And to be able to do that against these teams in this passing lead, that's the best thing you can do. Because with the defensive backs that we have, you can see they can really pick the ball and help our offense out, get the ball more.
Jeff Hathorn?
Stephon, along those lines, what is it about this defense that allows it to make that key pick or that key stop or key turnover at the right time?
Resiliency. I would probably say that we're a defense as well. We're a defense that, you know, we can bend, but we won't break. We're a defense that knows a lot of people within it from a couple of years that we've been playing together and very comfortable with each other. We know how we play and we capitalize off of each other from the rush to the defensive back to making great stops on, you know, great receivers. So we just got to continue to play as a team. And the more we do that, the better we'll be.
Will Graves.
Hey, Steph, you know, you guys have played pretty well in the two games against when you faced Jackson. I mean, you know, he called the Chiefs, I guess, kryptonite to him, you know, after he lost to them early in the season. Do you guys feel like you've got figured out a little something when facing him that maybe some other teams haven't?
Well, that is a big division opponent for us. So, yes, we see them more times than a lot of other teams get a chance to see them. But it's not about just figuring them out. We just know they got prolific athletes, and we know just how sound football we need to play against this team when we play them. And the more and more we do that, the better opportunity that we have. We match up very well, and they match up well with us. And if we don't go out there and play great football, you know, they could beat us. And if we go out there and play great football, we could beat them.
Joe Rutter.
Yes, Stephon. Sorry, I got on late, but I don't know if you were asked this, but what, you know, how have you guys find the best way to adapt with these Thursday games and prepare for them?
I don't know. You just, you know, you do your best. Everything is crammed within a couple of days right after another game. You know, you prepare for one game and also prepare for another game when you have a Thursday game at the same time. So this is a big game for us. And I think we just know already that type of atmosphere is going to bring. I think everybody do their best to try to keep their schedule. Everybody tries their best to be able to study as much tape and to be honest, study the last time you played this opponent. So that, I think that's what everybody's going to be trying to do and, you know, jam in as much as they can before we get a chance to play Thursday.
All right, let's go back to Brooke Pryor.
Yes, Stephon, this isn't just any Thursday game. It's a Thanksgiving night game. Is there added excitement? Obviously, you know, you said it's a five-star matchup. It's a division opponent. But what does playing on Thanksgiving on a day that there's so many good football games and being in that headlining spot, what does that mean to you guys? And does that get you guys even more amped up for it?
Well, personally, for me, I'm not going to speak for anyone else, but for me, it's very exciting. Thanksgiving is actually one of my favorite holidays, and it is a chance to have food and everybody get together and, you know, grub and do the things that you love to do and watch football. To be able to play on it and know that that's what families are doing is a huge honor for us to be in this scene and be in that set. And to be honest, it's very exciting. It's motivational for me to go out there and try to have a great game so I can try to get a turkey leg at the end.
Do you get to eat before the game at all? You're going to have any turkey before, or is that just for after?
Just for after. So we need to make sure, you know, after the game that we're on the winning side of things.
Will Graves?
Steph, I'm curious. The coaches have talked a lot about the limitations that the, you know, virtual meetings present. They can't look you guys in the eyes and stuff like that. I'm curious, as a player, what are the challenges, you know, what's it like for you guys? And in a way, does it help that you have such a veteran team that maybe guys are more mature and kind of know what to do off the field away from the coaches to sort of better prepare themselves individually?
You exactly said it. I was just about to say that. You took the words right out of my mouth. It's just, we got a lot of veteran guys that's already on the team that been a part of this process already. So, you know, coach, of course the coaches would love to meet us in front, face to face, but just due to the rules and the implication of the rules from the NFL, and not only the NFL, the state, that we have to honor, and we just have to, you know, we follow code and we have to do the things that we need to do to still try to be that close-knit team that even though we're not face-to-face, we're doing it virtually. And that's what we're going to have to continue to do. And I think we do a better job probably than some other teams because of that camaraderie of that, a lot of guys playing together that's, you know, that been here for a while, that veteran leadership from the team.